Hey everybody, this is Dax. You are you, and that's what gives us our memories, right? We're all unique. It's a lovely thing, being different. So I've said before, I'm from Texas originally, and I love all genres of music, including country and Merle Haggard, which I'm going to be doing a reaction to here in a minute. My dad, when I was growing up, listened to country, Johnny Cash, Conway Twitty, George Jones, Patsy Cline, Dolly Parton, Tammy Wynette. My mom was more into pop, the Beatles, all that stuff, a little bit of rock and roll. And when I was by myself in my room, I listened to both of those and I listened to rock and roll. So, and I got into classical music when I was in my 20s and, you know, jazz and some other stuff and reggae and things like that. But anyway, so a lot of people have bad things to say about country music. You know, I don't have much tolerance for those people. So anyway, there is some great country music, especially from the 60s and 70s and early 80s. I'm not too crazy about it after that, except for George Strait and a few others. But there is some sublime music from the 60s and 70s, country music from the 60s and 70s and early 80s. And well written. These guys lived sometimes tough lives, hard drinking lives, hard living lives, whatever, but they put it down and it's just great, great music. So I didn't listen to a whole lot of it before I turned 18, but after I turned 18, I ended up hanging out with a bunch of guys, great buddies of mine, and all of us except one guy were huge rock and roll fanatics. I was in Pink Floyd, Zeppelin, all that stuff. Anyway, one of the guys in our group was a huge country fan. I mean, that's almost all he listened to, except for some Billy Joel and some other stuff. But anyway, so we had a rule. We went out almost every Friday and Saturday night for 4 years between the age of 18 and 22. And hard living, you know. But my friend, Mike, was his name. We had a rule that every Friday and Saturday night, it rotated around and one person got to say where everybody had to go to drink and dance and all that stuff. Yeah, we danced back then. Danced till you started sweating and kept sweating. It's a great time. But anyway, so that friend, Mike, he always picked country music. So this was in between Dallas and Fort Worth, and we would go on his nights, we would go to Fort Worth. On our nights, we'd probably go to Dallas, you know, for rock and roll. So anyway, so I just got closer to country music. You know, we go to Billy Bob's and all these other places, honky tonks in the Fort Worth area. We bought boots and we, you know, boot scooted. And anyway, so I really got close to it. A lot of great singers, John Conley, Merle Haggard, George Jones, George Strait, and just a bunch of male and female singers that I love. But anyway, so I love country music for about that 25-year period. Anyway, this is one of the best songs of that period. This is a philosophical song. The writing on I think this is one of the greatest love songs of all time. It is one of the greatest love songs of all time. Merle Haggard's favorite memory. Favorite memory. And the way he sings it, the pacing on it, his guitar, his voice, the lyrics themselves, this is just off the charts. Great. One of the probably top 10 country songs of all time. So enough said. I looked at a bunch of his concert performances, and unfortunately, they didn't have any that were close to the song coming out. The concert performances just weren't quite as gut-wrenching and exuberant and lovely as this song is. So, as his original is on the 81 LP. So, anyway, so I'm just going to do this, where it's just going to be pictures of him doing the original song. So, let's listen to Merle Haggard do Favorite Memory. So here we go.
Mm-hmm. first time we met is a favorite memory of mine. They say time changes all it pertains to, but your memory is stronger than time.
It's a man's voice.
I guess everything does change except what you choose to recall. There's a million good daydreams to dream on, but baby, you are my favorite memory of all. Like the night we made love in the hallway, slept all night long on the floor. Like the winter we spent on Lake Shasta, alone and closer than ever before. And I remember that London vacation. It was you who made the whole thing a ball. There's a million good times I could dwell on, but baby, you are my favorite memory of all. Time we met is a favorite memory of mine. You say time changes all it pertains to, but your memory is stronger than time. I guess everything does change except you choose to recall. A million good daydreams to dream on, but baby, you are my favorite memory of all.
Goodness. How about that for a voice? That husky male voice singing a love melody to his memory. That song really moves me. Damn. I just love that sort of slow pace and the richness of Merle's voice. And what he's singing about. His favorite memory. I just love the freaking lyrics on this. They say time changes all it pertains to, but your memory is stronger than time. Your memory is stronger than time. They say time changes all it pertains to, but your memory is stronger than time. I'm not sure there's a better love lyric ever. Your memory is stronger than time. And I guess everything does change except what you choose to recall. There's a million good daydreams to dream on, but baby, you are my favorite memory of all. And then I love how he goes into like the specific details of the relationship. You know, the night they made love in the hallway, slept all night long on the floor. The winter they spent on Lake Shasta, alone, closer than ever before. And he remembers that London vacation, and it was her who made the whole thing a ball. If this song doesn't remind you of somebody, it does me. If it doesn't remind you of that person and how they are your favorite memory of all, then you probably can't connect to this song. It's just such a gorgeous love song by a man who's a real man. You know, Merle spent 3 years in prison, St. Quentin prison. I think it was 57 to 60. Yeah, he was a bad boy. Got his life straight. He was a drinker, of course, like most country boys back then. Too much. But got it together and started putting his feelings and thoughts into lyrics and had a great voice. He could also do great impressions of other singers. He was pretty impressive. But this song, I do karaoke. I've said before that I do karaoke occasionally. I've got a karaoke whole setup in my basement and friends come over and we do it. And this is my song probably that I do more than any other song when I sing. Just, it's right for my voice, but also I just really connect to it. Anyway, that's Merle Haggard with Favorite Memory. And nobody does it like Merle. Okay. Just let me know what y'all think. Look forward to your comments. And I will catch you on the backside. Take care of yourselves. Bye now.